Okay.
Hamitic.
And right from the beginning of the world and up to Veda and Tamil concept, that is two types of concept. And for Aryan, they don't have any written concept.
Concept.
Only for Tamilians, they do have a written concept. The written concept will be of starting with Adam to Noah. And now it has been Asivagam concept. The same Asivagam concept, it has been followed by the Quran.
Yeah, followed by a family of Ibrahim, where all the prophets came. And from family of Ibrahim, we have Prophet Muhammad.
So, if the same pattern has been followed by the Quran, and do you think that Iran, Iraq and all other majority in the Muslims countries and one go following the Quran concept, they're all Tamilians or different other races?
They are actually settlers. Settlers, because as I told you, from Turkey to Indus Valley belongs to Tamil nation. But after the invasion of Aryans and Persian Empire and Roman Empire, those land was occupied by settlers. And settlers are hiding behind the Muslim label. Shia, Sufi, Wahhabi, all this. Because see, in the 7th century, Islam got completed. Quran got completed, Islam got completed. The Islam we started from Shiva. This Islam which the Quran talks about is talking about the first Siddha, Islam.
Okay.
The first Siddha is Shiva, and whatever the information which God gave to Shiva, that rules and regulation, minor changes has been taken place in Quran. Like for example, in the Old Testament, only 10 commandments were given to children of Israel.
Okay.
So like every period, based on their capacity, God judged whether this community will take up the law or not. Okay. So the Quran is basically just a changing of rules, little slight change in laws. Quran is a continuation. It's connected with the first Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Ibrahim.
Okay.
And the first is Tamil, and first Siddha is Shiva. So Shiva, whatever the Shiva got the rules and regulation, it's been followed by the completed that rules and regulation. Now no new rules will come.
Okay.
It's completed.
Okay. So as per your concept is in 7th century, Islam got completed. The rules and regulation for
whatever the abrogation or any deletion or addition is there has been completed.
So the regulations, its concept is in terms of how to lead the life. And
so already the life is already been given to Shiva. Every rules and regulation of mode of worship, everything has been mode how to govern the people. Everything is with Shiva. The same thing has been talked by Prophet Quran and Prophet Muhammad.
Okay.
The only few, like for example, I'll give you that inter-caste marriage. In Asivagam, it was not allowed.
Okay.
But after this, Quran has allowed the you can marry your slave, like lower caste, even the labor class people, you can marry. The elites can marry the labor class.
Okay. So the complete shape of the governing the people and give birth and all that, the people morality and the principle of to live their life and all that have been completed in the 7th century. In terms
No. It's, the rules and regulation is already there with Shiva. Shiva is there, but only few rules and regulation are amended. Change little bit.
I agree. Because already the rules and regulations given by the God to Shiva.
Yeah.
Shiva is the
Asivagam,
ultimate,
yeah.
The ultimate person who have been narrated all the rules and regulations.
Yeah.
The narrated regulation, the written
government
document
system, everything, whatever,
yes,
how to live the life.
Different.
But the mode of worship is still the same. Yoga, meditation, Kundalini chakra, and standing behind the elected minister.
That completely remain be the same.
Same.
So there has been derived from the God to Shiva. So Shiva has been written the document, that is called the Asivagam. So that Asivagam completed in the 7th century. Thus, after the 7th century, the few amendments taken place in the 8th century, that is
no, 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 not 8th century. 7th century last.
7th century
full
last.
Stop. No amendment. 8th century, we are the people who changed the rules and regulation are the not from the Tamil race. They are from Aryan settlers.
Okay.
Like how Jesus said. Jesus said in the Bible that you cannot cancel the old law. We have to follow the old law.
Yes.
But Saint Paul says that you don't have to follow the law. Who is Saint Paul? Saint Paul is a Greek Aryan.
Yes.
Similarly, Saint Paul never saw Jesus Christ. He cannot be an apostle because apostle means one who is with Jesus Christ. So he is having a put himself as a own apostle. He has claimed he's an apostle, but as per technical term, he is not an apostle.
Yes.
Similarly, same thing happened with Prophet Muhammad. After the completion of Quran, Asivagam, then the Aryan settlers, Roman and Persian, they started interpolating, corrupting the system, because they want the Varna Dharam, caste system to be maintained. And Asivagam is not based on caste system, untouchability. It's like people were living in the golden age before, prior to untouchable era. They were living in the golden age. What was the system? Because the system at that time was that common people took an active part in administration. So ruling and the common people were equal.
Good.
Okay. The same thing applies with Prophet Muhammad also said the same thing. What is Jummah? Friday prayer. Friday prayer is behind the Khalifa, appointed minister.
Yes.
What we are doing? We are standing behind Pujari. Okay. Brahmin system.
Yes.
So nothing is there. It's just ritual is happening over there.
Okay.
But the ultimate goal is to bring peace among the society. This is what the meaning of Islam means.
Correct.
Peace. Peace between the society. We are living together. Peace between the animal kingdom, plant kingdom, space, air kingdom, animal, birds. We have to live in harmony with everyone.
All right.
So the 8th century Shia Aryans, Persian Aryan, they started Shia concept. 8th okay. century.
Okay.
9th century Sunni concept came about.
Okay.
13th century Sufism came about. 18th century Wahhabi came about. Wahhabis are Saudi. Saudis are not real Arabs. Real Arabs are black. Those are Aryan settlers.
Okay.
Okay.
So
the means the fight is between the cousin, between two cousin system. One is Shiva, Tamil, and Aryans are cousin brothers.
Okay.
You can rectify Europe. Europe, after the First World War, Second World War, they entered into spiritualism and they rectified themselves. But since Aryan settlers, the coming of Antichrist, which the Bible talks about, and the Hadith talks about the coming of Dajjal, the Kali Yuga was started by the Aryan settlers.
Okay.
So we are fighting with the two cousins are fighting over the system.
Okay.
So they are basically corrupting the official, corrupting the people, corrupting, maintaining the Brahminism system.
Okay.
See, today Aryavarta, today what is happening in India, like today Arya in India and in minority. Aryavarta concept is not possible in India.
Okay.
But still that funding is coming from Saudi, a Muslim world. Because by DNA they are what? Roman Empire, Persian Empire. Quran chapter 49 verse 13 clearly says to identify by race and tribe.
Okay.
Not by religion.
Okay.
Faith is something personal to you.
Okay.
What you are, I cannot see.
Yes.
But by race, I can see whether he's Chinese, whether he's African or Semitic or European or Aryan or Tamil. So we have to identify as per tribe. This is what Quran says. We have to identify by race. So based on race history, I went into Tamil race history, Mongolian race history. This different history. What is the history of Europe? They say they are living in the dark ages. Gay, lesbian, animal sex, all the anti-spiritual they are following. But after First World War, Second World War, they were rectified. But after the in contact with Wahhabism, again they went into dark ages. They are struggling.
Okay.
See, today we have the single currency in Europe.
Yes.
So people are not running after money.
Yes.
There is peace in society.
Mm.
Mafia is gone.
Mm.
But today, today in India, we are living in a state of confusion.
Mm.
There's no proper, all the Dalit movement, Periyar movement, every Dravidian movement has failed.
Mm.
And ultimately, Brahmins are still in power. How is it possible?
Okay.
They have come in power.
Okay.
So, this, until unless we don't go back to the Shivaite system, the Koil system, and common people going into Koil and fighting for their rights, then only equality will come. Na?
So, Quran also amended in the Tamil language or in Arabic language?
No, Arabic language.
Arabic language. Why it has been changed, sir?
See, Arabic language, why? Because the Prophet is from Arab. And Quran not only talks about Tamil, it talks about Ibrahim also. The Quran says, statement is there in Quran saying that the Prophet is in Arabia. His language is Arabic. We will give him a revelation in Arabic. He will understand and then he will guide you.
Okay. So, as per your concept that in 7th century, Muhammad Nabi is the Prophet.
He's a Prophet.
So, he's lived in 7th century.
From 630 was, I think, 632 was the last.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, that is the last.
Yeah.
So, but also, though it is written in the Arabic, it is follower of the
continuation. Chapter 42 verse 13.
It is continuation of Lord Shiva Masivaka concept.
Yeah, yeah. because chapter 42 verse 13 clearly says the religion, the school of thought which Prophet Muhammad followed was what Noah followed, and Noah is from the genealogy of Shiva. Set, okay. As per biblical.
Okay.
And whatever Asivagam knowledge is carried is continuation. And the same religion has been followed by Ibrahim, Ismail, Isaac, Yaqub. It's written in the chapter 42, verse 13.
So, Bible and Quran and Lord Shiva, they are one and the same.
One same.
The everything concept is
God
same.
Is one.
God is one.
God is one. And okay. his books are all one from okay. one source. It's a continuation.
Okay. In the continuation of dynasty and one person, Aryan, it is the cursed people, yeah. They are not civilized so far. So they wanted to be civilized once again. So they are building the concept of Sana. So far they are building the concept of Sana, so they are dividing the people of Varnasaram Dharmam.
Yeah.
And for that they are dividing people into the Sudras and Shias and all that. All the concept will be come into after which.
See,
because the concept is building only for the concept of civilization of Aryans.
Yeah. No, actually they wanted to take over like Shiva. Basically, when one race occupies another race, it's quite natural that the learned, administrator, corporate will be in their hand, and the yes. and the native will become Shudra or labor, untouchable.
Yes.
So the Indian population were following the Asivagam system, Koil system, where okay. they were actively taking part in administration.
Yes.
After the coming of Aryans, their rights were taken away. So they were not allowed to enter into Koil. Koil means parliament, house of an elected minister.
Okay.
And then later they made it into idol worship, avatar system.
Okay.
So there's two different principles. One is creation and balance, and other is evolution. Aryan sector talks about evolution theory. Thus avatara and all this are evolution theory and mythology.
Yes. Okay.
So we Shiva is fact, and Varnadharam and all this Kaliya, this is all mythology. Okay. Until today they are not ready to accept Tamil as a civilized society.
But yeah. as per the historical the research is concerned, Tamil is the first thing,
the only civilized race on earth.
Civilized the cultivations.
Yeah, and they attribute to alien Anunnaki and all those.
Okay, even for the pyramid concept also, Tamilian.
Tamil. There was no other race only, na? So, from a single male and female. Bible says that, and Quran
Adam
also.
And Eve.
Adam yeah. and Eve. From that only the genealogy spread.
Okay.
So the story divided is into three parts. Cain, Abel, Seth. Seth is Shiva.
Okay.
And rest is all the followers of Shiva.
So in the world and no other race has been there, and the first race has been initiated by the god is Tamil
yeah,
race.
Tamil race.
So now after the Tamil race, and because of the first murder taken place by the Cain,
yeah.
So the race has been divided into two, Tamilian and
Aryan.
So the cursed race to people is called the comes in by Aryan people.
Cain, children of Cain.
Children of Cain.
Actually, the word Aryan means noble.
Okay.
That word is also been hijacked by them.
Okay. Okay.
that Aryan label should have been given to Tamil people.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
But they tell them that they are Shudra, untouchable, Harijan. All these various labels.
So they don't have any concept of civilization.
Yeah.
They don't have a concept of administration skills.
No.
And they have built the civilization concept. So that is called Varnasara Dharma.
Yeah, Varnasaram. Varna is there. Four profession is already there. Without profession, you cannot live. But the rights of administration is taken away from the labor class. No?
Yes.
They are not allowed to enter into Koil. So if you want, you see, we cannot end the profession. We need a learned, administrator, corporate and labor. This is the system.
Yes, this is the system.
We cannot change the system.
Yes.
But we can bring equality between the ruling class and the labor class. How? Through Koil system. We ruling and common people should take an active part in administration.
Okay. So the term, the Koil that you pronounce, the term is?
House of elected minister. King.
Okay. Procedure to electing the king of kingdom.
Kingdom, yeah.
So in earlier it was in Koil, the term is called Koil.
Koil, parliament.
Now it is called a temple.
Yeah, it's not, they have made it into avatar temple.
Okay.
Avatar is not a concept of Shiva, right?
Okay. So they have changed
yeah.
into the simple, the temple is only for the purpose of worship.
Worship, yeah.
But initial stage is the purpose of electing the kingdom.
Kingdom. And plus, see, when God is within us, the Atma is within us, we have to just activate it and connect to higher conscious. For that, you don't need any temple. It's your personal, you can sit in any corner of your house and do it.
Okay, in Bible also in saying that. And since you are the temple, you are the church.
Yeah.
So that is the same Bible symbol. So all the concept will be abiding with the Bible, natural Quran, as well the Asivagam
concept. Sir.
So now all the Christian dynasty, all the Mahamadian and all other the Veera Vainavamsh and Shaivam and all the people in Tamilian will be of Tamil race.
Tamil race. They will be of Tamil race, and they have to follow Shiva. Because if you don't follow Shiva Koyal system, there will be no peace. The ruling and opposition will loot the whole India and the whole world.
They are the Muslim, they have to follow Shiva concept.
Yeah, they have to, because Quran is talking. If they are Muslim, then they should follow Quran.
Okay.
They are not following Jumma system.
Okay.
Jumma is supposed to be behind elected minister.
Okay.
Kingdom, they are following, there is no election system over there. There is no Khalifa system over there. They are just following, blind following their Pujari, Ulamas.
Okay.
And they are giving vague fatwas.
How come the Muslims are accepted and accept now? Because they are very rigid in their following system of Mahmudan laws and all that.
See, if you go back in the Bible, the Gentiles are settlers. Jesus Christ clearly says in the Bible, I have come only for the lordship of house of Israel, not for Gentiles. Gentiles are the Aryan settlers.
Okay.
And Bible calls them children of swine.
Okay.
And same thing when Quran chapter 36, 1 to 5. The comforter is nothing but Prophet Muhammad.
Yes.
And the last prophet when he came, the Quran chapter 36, 1 to 11 clearly says that you have been sent to a people whose forefathers were not warned. They had no warner. So they are heedless. If you warn them or you do not warn them, they will not believe. They are stiff-necked.
Aryan and Mongolian.
Yeah.
The two race or the...
No, Aryan settlers, not those people.
Aryan settlers.
Settlers.
Okay, Aryan settlers, that you mean to that who have been cursed people.
The race is cursed. If you see karma concept and DNA concept, they are cursed. But the coming of Antichrist. Coming of Antichrist refers to Roman Empire, Persian Empire, who are now hiding behind the Muslim label.
So Roman
Empire and Persian Empire. Because Jerusalem is a city of which race? Semitic black,
Semitic
Negroes.
Black, yes.
Semitic black.
Yes.
It has been, when Jesus said, I have come only for the lordship of house of Israel, because of Roman Empire, Persian Empire, those children of Israel, they migrated to Arab and Africa. They migrated. Jesus Christ's mission is incomplete. And chapter 17, verse 104, clearly says that end of time, before that is when the Jesus comes, he is going to bring back the children of Israel back to the, and take his old Qibla, old administration center Jerusalem, and the new Qibla, that is Makkah, the administration center of Bani Israel, children of Israel, to them.
So now the Mecca is for?
It's for Bani Israel only, but it has been illegally occupied by the Saudis, Aryans.
Aryans. Now, what is the purpose of Mecca, sir?
Makkah is a get-together of a tribals. Like I said, it's a tribal get-together of Semitic blacks.
Okay. So in earlier, Mecca was Israel.
No, see the Koyal system, administration center, because see, from Turkey to Indus Valley belongs to Tamilian. But after the defeat of Pandyan kingdom, the first king among the Bani Israel was Saul. As per the Bible and Quran, the first king among the Bani Israel was Saul. And then David came, killed Goliath, and Suleiman built the first temple of temple of Suleiman.
Okay.
Because administration, the right.
Okay.
Is with Tamil Shiva genealogy, Sage genealogy.
Okay. And so far, Aryans are trying to defeat the Tamilian civilization.
Tamil
they want
as
to
well
implement their own civilization.
Aryavarta concept is what?
Okay.
Aryavarta means complete domination of Aryan rules on Tamil land.
Tamil.
But since Tamil Nadu is a part of cradle of civilization, and from this land, Cain was cursed and banished. And because of that curse and banish of God, they are not getting entry in Tamil Nadu. Something is happening that they have been stopped. The only thing for them is they are afraid of is Tamil Nadu.
Okay.
Because this is the cradle of civilization. This is Jallikattu. All of a sudden, people have come. It's a Shivite concept, na?
Because
DNA, because they are, and plus Trikonamala is the real Kailash. LTT, they fought for that Trikonamala, no? The purpose behind the LTT war was for Trikonamala.
Okay.
So the Trikonamala is the real Kailash of Shiva.
So the Kailash which has been located in the Himalayas, that is not actual
Kailash.
That's a fake Kailash.
Because see, like how Jesus is black, they painted him white.
Okay.
Aryan are cave people.
Okay.
So they painted Shiva as a cave people.
So Shiva is completely black.
He's a black man, so he's an administrator with how administrator lives. He will live that way, na.
Okay, he's the first administrator of Tamilian, and he lives in Tamil land. So that is the Kumarikandam.
Kumarikandam.
So Tirugonamalai is the Kailash.
Kailash, real Kailash.
So that is the living place of Lord Shiva.
Lord Shiva. Himalaya is a fake Kailash.
Okay.
Because they have portrayed Shiva as their own race.
Okay.
You're getting the point? Because, see, all the religion belongs to Aryans. Holy books belongs to black people.
All right, sir. And thank you so much for the time you're spending with us. And you're giving a lot number of information through your research. And this is completely a new dimension that has been given to our people for understanding of the history and all that. Because so far we are thinking that three kind of the major ism we are followed by the across the global and majorly Christianity and Hinduism and Muslim Mughmaran. And now we come to a conclusion that Mughmaran and Christianity both are brothers and sisters, and they are been taking in one race, and they do have a written document of set of principles.
Yeah.
The all principles that termly called as Asivagam by Lord Shiva. So after which so far the revolution has been given to Prophet Muhammad, and that has been written in Arabic language.
Yeah.
So that is an Asivagam concept again.
Asivagam, reminding the Asivagam concept.
Asivagam concept.
The Quran clearly says it's a reminder.
All right.
It's not a book of conversion.
Okay, it's a reminder.
It's a reminder.
All right.
And people who don't have anything, like how don't have any books of honor, how can the Quran be their reminder?
So it is not we're talking about for the ism, we're talking about the DNA and race.
Race only.
So and language.
Yeah.
So that is the main thing that we have to follow. That is why we have to understand in future.
Yeah.
So
identify by race and tribe.
All right. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving in time and all that.
Thank you.
And this is going to be a great start and great new type of dimension of thinking of people. And this is going to be a very big, great success for your future. And as for Tamil Kudiyar So channel, and we wish you a lot and lot success, and give us a lot more beautiful information or history. So for our Tamilians, and we do have only for grammatical evidence, we don't have any historical evidence, and latestly we just come to know for Kiradi and all that, and this information are all completely quite different, and we can come to know that how it has been driven out and all that.
See, it's in Kiradi civilization there is no idol found. That's why in the first 2 years, I think, center stopped the funding of excavation. It was the state government who started the excavation, because there was no evidence of their Vedic age.
Yes, yes.
They stopped it.
Yes.
So there's it's like a stepson. Center is just considering Tamil as a stepson.
All right. So still they're trying to establish their own Aryan
civilization.
They suppress the Tamilian civilization. Okay, all the way, because truth will coming out of one day. So now you are taking care of it, and thank you so much for the part of this show, sir.